Well, the STP-2 mission was an astounding success, with Falcon Heavy perfectly delivering all its cargo into orbit. Everything went perfectly well, except for this small little mishap here.
And then, while Starhopper is still waiting for hopping tests, we see some progress on the actual Starship prototypes, currently being assembled in Texas and Florida. No news on the Artemis Moon mission this week. However, we got another extremely cool upcoming mission revelation from NASA.
A freaking flying drone to be sent to the fascinating and exotic Saturn moon of Titan. That is... So stay tuned for these news and more on this week's episode of Space News. So the Falcon Heavy lifted off on June 25th at 2:30 in the morning from the historic launch pad 39A at the Kennedy Space Center. It flew to orbit exactly as planned and delivered its payload, consisting of 24 smaller satellites, which we detailed in our last space video, which you can watch right here. Everything went pretty smoothly. The rocket's two side boosters made a synchronized landing on neighboring pads at the former launch complex 13 at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, several kilometers to the south of the launch site.
But unfortunately, the center core could not land successfully on the drone ship that had been prepared for its landing, 1,200 kilometers off the Florida coast in the Atlantic Ocean. So what went wrong? Well, this landing was extremely difficult, as Elon Musk pointed out, because the reentry speed of the center core was extremely high. Remember that on the first Falcon Heavy flight, the famous Starman launch, the center core also didn't manage to successfully land on the drone ship with the cool name, "Of Course I Still Love You." The second time, however, the center core actually managed to successfully land. And now the third time, it again didn't manage to land on the very same drone ship.
The reason was that the re-entry speed was extremely high this time, the highest of all the Falcon Heavy launches, up to 4 km per second, as Elon pointed out. Further, Elon stated that an analysis of available telemetry apparently indicated that this very fast and hot re-entry either burned through the center core's heavy titanium heat shield or broke through the smaller heat shield surrounding its Merlin engine bells. In short, the very fast and therefore very hot re-entry of the center core into the atmosphere probably damaged the center core's engine, the engine being absolutely necessary for a precise drone ship landing. But amazingly, the center core still almost managed to make it, landing only a few hundred meters away from the drone ship.
A viewer of our channel has pointed out that in order to increase the chances of successful center core landings, SpaceX should not attempt to land it on a drone ship, but instead parachute it down and let it land in a huge net. Well, we investigated this idea a bit further, and also another viewer pointed that out, that a parachute landing would be highly impractical, if not impossible. First of all, the parachutes cannot decelerate the rocket enough for a soft landing, and then they would weigh so much that they would make the rocket far too heavy. Also, parachute systems are not 100% reliable and need many secondary parts that could also fail. Therefore, simply landing the rocket is far more economical and also safer.
In other news, while Starhopper is still waiting for an engine installed to finally make it ready for the first real hopping tests, the two Starship prototypes in turn are really making some progress. So in case you didn't know, SpaceX is currently assembling the Starhopper, which is the in-atmosphere vertical takeoff and landing test vehicle for Starship, but at the same time is also assembling two Starship prototypes which will actually fly into orbit. The Starhopper and one of the Starship prototypes are being assembled in Boca Chica, Texas, while the other Starship prototype is being built in Cocoa, Florida.
Florida's orbital Starship prototype looks even more refined than its brother in Texas, giving an additional 1 to 2 months of non-stop work and a rate of progress similar to the last 2 months. It appears realistic that the Florida prototype might actually begin to resemble a finished Starship. However, some of the most difficult work will take place inside and around Starship's finished aeroshell, and the process of outfitting avionics, and plumbing the propellant sections and implementing hydraulic systems will be a huge amount of work.
The next few months will be very interesting in any case, and it's just wonderful to see such progress going on with Starhopper and the Starship prototypes. I mean, even the fact that SpaceX is building the Starhopper and two Starship prototypes at the same time is absolutely amazing. And let's just take a step back and think of this. Let us not forget that this is actually the single most important rocket or space vehicle that is being built since the Saturn V 50 years ago. And we're talking about the vehicle here that will take us back to the moon, that will take us to Mars, and hopefully even beyond Mars in the future. This is nothing less than the future of humanity in the solar system that is being built right here in front of our eyes. History is being made right now, and we can watch it.
So this week, no news on Artemis, the 2024 moon mission. But instead, we got a surprise announcement from NASA about a super exciting mission to one of our favorite places in the solar system. On the 27th of June, NASA announced the Dragonfly mission, a robotic flying unmanned drone that will be brought to Titan in order to fly around and observe the mysteries of this fascinating moon. Why is Titan so fascinating, you ask? Well, first of all, it's the only moon in the solar system with a thick atmosphere. And we're talking really thick here. The atmospheric pressure on the surface of Titan is 1.45 bar. The atmosphere is so thick that from space you can only see an orange blob with no surface details.
Radar observations, however, from Earth, but also in particular from the Cassini spacecraft, have shown that there's actually a lot going on the surface of Titan. There are giant lakes of liquid methane and ethane on the surface. Some of them, like Croc Mare, are with an area of 400,000 square kilometers, as large as all the Great Lakes of North America combined. But as if that wasn't outlandish enough, you have of course also rain of liquid methane and ethane on the surface, and also rivers. So you have, instead of a water cycle like on Earth, a liquid hydrocarbon cycle. Of course, in order for the hydrocarbons to be liquid, we need very cold temperatures, and the temperature on Titan is indeed very cold at minus 180 degrees Celsius or 93 Kelvin.
Also, on Titan there are all the basic ingredients for life, with an abundance of quite complex organic molecules. And there's more. Titan is bigger than the planet Mercury, but at the same time has a lower gravity than the Moon. Only 83.5% of the Moon's gravity because of its much lower density. So on Titan, the combination of the very thick and dense atmosphere together with the very low gravity would enable you to fly around in wingsuits. A concept wonderfully portrayed in the amazing animated short movie Wanderers by Eric Wernquist. We put the link into the description. It's an awe-inspiring and wonderful vision of the future of humanity in the solar system.
But if you're now jumping out of joy in anticipation for this cool mission, don't get too excited, please, because the mission is slated to launch in 2026. And Titan is quite far away, so the probe would arrive at Titan in 2034. We'll probably see humans return to the moon, hopefully with Starship, and Starship fly to Mars and land humans on Mars before we see Dragonfly arrive at Titan. But we are still absolutely thrilled and fascinated by this mission, because the notion alone of having this drone fly through the atmosphere of this incredibly fascinating world and explore the rain, the rivers, and the giant lakes of hydrocarbons is absolutely mind-boggling. It's a dream come true.
So, are you more excited about the Dragonfly mission or the Artemis mission? What do you think?
I'm excited for both. I want both.
But if you could only choose one?
I would choose the Dragonfly mission, because SpaceX will land on the Moon and Mars even without NASA.
Let us know your choice in the comment section.
And what do you think? Will the Starhopper finally do the hopping tests by the end of this month, or will it be delayed again? So we would be very glad if you would not share this video with your friends. Inverse psychology.
And be sure to turn on that notification bell so that you won't miss any amazing developments from the world of spaceflight. See you next time.
Ciao.